She is an image of softness and grace on the ice. Throughout her career, Michelle Kwan has epitomized a certain style. A spirit of determination mixed with a joy of simply being on the ice. She is like a rose forever blooming in a desert storm. Measured time like none other in the sport. Her stylistic refinements have produced 3 world championships and an Olympic silver medal. This tiny rose will always bloom anew. Today, her hair is longer, and her competitive fire still burns in her heart. The season starts tonight, and 1999 world champion Maria Butyrskaya is here to challenge Michelle. So, too, is world silver medalist Irina Slutskaya. Todd Eldridge leads a strong contingent of men, and the pairs are led by the Chinese twosome of Zhen and Zhao. It is now time for the Pearl Vision Masters, and these champions have gathered in the capital city of Idaho, Boise. The crowd is settling in at the Bank of America Center. Welcome to Boise, Idaho. Hello, everybody. I'm Tracy Wilson. Tonight's event is the first in a series of 3 competitions, which brings Olympic-eligible and professional skaters together in competition. They will compete in 2 numbers, first the Olympic-style short program and then the interpretive free program. And we will see competitions in the pairs, the men's, and the ladies. Joining me once again on our coverage, Olympic silver medalist Roslyn Sumners, and new to our team this year, the 1992 Olympic silver medalist Paul Wiley. This is the start of a new season. The Olympics is only 15 months away, Paul. How important is this season to the skaters?
This season is critical. In the season before the Olympics, you lay the foundation for how you skate there. The world's best are pushing themselves here to test out new programs and quadruple jumps. They have to ratchet up the difficulty, and this is their testing ground. 3-time world champion Alexei Yagodin is in incredible shape. He's here doing quad and triple combinations with 2 new programs. Todd Eldridge has declared he wants to compete in Salt Lake City. He knows he needs a quad, so he'll be trying it here, hoping to land it for the first time.
Well, they will have to contend with the current Olympic champion, who's now a professional, Ilya Kulik. How does Ilya stack up?
Well, for the past 2 years, Tracy, Ilya has been focusing on his choreography and style. Remember, 2/3 of the final result in this competition is based on the interpretive program, so he has a chance to win his first championship since the Olympics.
Strong field in the men, Paul, but boy, the ladies, Roslyn, we have first, second, and third from the podium at the recent World Championships, and of course, the leader once again, Michelle Kwan.
And wow, Tracy, when Michelle is competing in an event, she raises the level of skating and competitive intensity. You can just feel it in the practices. Michelle Kwan is skating, and she has set a new standard in the sport. Each new season brings her new challenges physically and mentally, and that is what she thrives on. But she is not without hungry competitors behind her, and the 2 that put on that pressure are Maria Butyrskaya and Irina Slutskaya. Maria lost her world title to Michelle last season, and she wants it back. She is determined to be the one to seize the moment if anything affects Michelle and leaves an opening. And Irina is pushing both of them technically. These are the 2 that can beat Michelle. They know it, and she knows it.
And Roz, I think we can all agree that Michelle's season last year was personally very satisfying. For more on Michelle Kwan, let's go backstage now and join Dee Lynam.
Thanks, Tracy. Michelle Kwan is to women's figure skating what Tiger Woods is to golf, in this sense. She is the draw. She is always expected to win. A year ago this time, we were all wondering how Michelle would balance college and skating. Michelle answered with a resounding, yes, I can. Now she is 20 years old, she's a new homeowner, and she's lightened her course load a little bit, but she's also projecting this newfound sense of independence. She's a young woman with a plan, a goal, and a mindset.
I'm always thinking ahead. I definitely know that I have a schedule to keep up on, and you want to be ready for the nationals and the worlds. And of course, the Olympics down the line, everybody's been talking about, it's only 16 months away, 15, and it's a big countdown. I felt that last year I was able to pull it off at the very end at the World Championships. And through the year, most of the critics were like, oh, Michelle's all over. She's got too much to handle. She's gonna turn pro after this year, and so on and so forth. And I was just like, no, this is what I want to do. I love school, and I love skating. And why not, if you have the mind for it, be able to juggle both? And I think I silenced the critics for a little while. We'll see what they say this year.
Well, Michelle, those critics will always be there. You just keep on silencing them. When we return, two-time world champions Berezhnaya and Seeker Lidze on the ice for their short program.
Welcome to the Pearl Vision Masters of Figure Skating. I'm George Bernstein, president of Pearl Vision. Tonight, you're going to see some of the finest figure skaters in the world. As professionals committed to delivering excellence in eye care, Pearl Vision is proud to sponsor this exciting event. We hope you enjoy the inspirational performances of these world-class champions.
Thank you, George, and we certainly appreciate Pearl Vision's involvement with figure skating. World champions Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Seeker Lidze have found themselves in third place after the pair's short program. The early season program rust was evident in their performance. So too was the memory of what happened to them at the 2000 World Championships. Here is how Roslyn and I called their short program. On the ice now, two-time world champions Elena Berezhnaya, Anton Seeker Lidze of Russia. They were not allowed to compete at this year's Worlds due to Elena's failed drug test at Europeans. She took an over-the-counter cold medication and was suspended for 3 months. This is their first competition since the suspension, and they will skate to Meadowland. This number was choreographed by ice dancer Christopher Dean, which is going to bring in a lot of different unusual moves in the choreography. And they're going to open with their side-by-side triple toes. Beautiful. They actually jump the same in the air. They rotate, everything is exactly the same. Double twist. Here comes the throw triple loop. No, she got in the air and was completely off balance. That was a huge mistake, huge deduction. That was a mistake they couldn't afford. Tracy, that's 0.3 tenths taken off for that. Off right away in unison at the beginning of the spins. I sort of feel
feel their nerves. It feels flat to me. Not just the mistake on the throw. Everything just doesn't feel as crisp as we usually see from them. Is sporting a fat lip. Elena caught him with her elbow in training 4 days prior to coming here to Boise, and he had plastic surgery on it the next day. Back death spiral. She needs to get all the way arched back, as far down. Beautiful. Oh, gosh. Mistakes that we're not used to seeing from these two. Really a lack of control. I mean, that was really a simple move for them. Can't even hang on to that. The fall in the loop really has affected their confidence. Wow. Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikhralidze, world champions from Russia. All the potential in the world, but once again, failing to realize it. The short program, Zhuiya Zhen and Hongbo Zhao of China are in first place, ahead of the U.S. national champions Kyoka Ina and John Zimmerman. Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikhralidze are in third. When we come back, American Todd Eldridge takes on the defending world champion from Russia, Alexei Yagudin.
Our first competitor in the men's short program, representing Russia, Ilya Kulik.
First on the ice with his men's short program, the current Olympic champion, now a professional from Russia. Here is 23-year-old Ilya Kulik, and he will skate to Devil's Trill by Vanessa May.
Tracy, Ilya opens tonight with a triple axel double toe loop. Did not perform these in practice at all. Here it comes. Triple axel. Triple toe loop. Beautiful. That was amazing.
How unusual not to practice it, but to be able to throw it in competition.
Ilya is unconventional in every way. He coaches himself. He has himself as a choreographer. And I'm impressed. Here comes the second of eight elements, a triple Lutz. Hand down, that'll be a deduction, but really a great beginning. Taken the last 2 years and really focused on his choreography. This footwork makes him among the best in the world at footwork. Right into a double axel. He's known for like short transitions. Ilya is known for his short transitions. He goes from one jump to the next with no crossovers or connecting moves.
After winning the Olympic title in Nagano in 1998, Ilya turned professional, and he said he lost interest in working on his jumps, and he has put a lot of his focus into the footwork and the choreography of his programs. He now lives and trains in Los Angeles.
I think there may actually be a slight deduction in that stars into flying camel move.
Ilya Kulik of Russia has not competed a program like this for over a year, an Olympic-style short program. The relief evident on his face.
Now Now here he goes into his triple axel combination. That's 3.5 rotations taking off from a forward outside edge. Watch him take his arms, swing through, nice tight legs, 3 rotations on a triple toe loop. Just about the most difficult triple combination you can do.
And now the marks for Ilya Kulik of Russia. The first set, Paul, for required elements quite low.
They are, and I think that reflects some deductions. He actually had a couple revolutions short on a sit spin. He had a deduction for a foot touchdown on a spin and a hand touchdown on an element on the triple lutz.
Judges in agreement on his presentation marks 5 sevens across the board for Ilya Kulik, first to skate in the men's short program. On the ice now, 5-time U.S. national champion, the 1996 world champion, 29 years of age. Here is Todd Eldridge. Has not competed in a Worlds or Nationals for 2 years, said he needed a break, but he's coming back for one reason, and that is to win an Olympic medal. His journey starts here with this program. The quad, a necessary ingredient for Todd, Paul, and it's first up in the program.
Absolutely, and this would make a little history for Todd tonight, the first time he will have landed it, if he should. There's got to be a lot of pressure on him to make a breakthrough performance tonight. Gets right into it. He'll gather the speed. He's thinking right now, I've got to make this. I've got to make this breakthrough in my life right now. Here comes a quadruple toe loop. He triples it. It's a triple toe, double toe. No deduction. But we'll have to wait for the quad for another time. I'm sure he's disappointed, but you know, it's so great that he's out here trying it now. He waited until the Olympics to try it. It wouldn't happen. Coming up the triple axel, the most difficult triple jump. He has a great one. Triple axel. Up, step out. So much of his concentration going into the quad that I think it probably, you know, unnerved him a little bit. Triple lutz out of footwork, also a difficult one. Puts both hands down there. He's looking at some deductions in the technical mark, and the base mark will be low since he didn't do the quad.
Todd attempted his first quadruple jump in competition at the 1996 U.S. Nationals, but this is the first time, Paul, he's tried it in the short program. That's a very different thing, isn't it?
That's right. This is the first time that you've actually been able to do a quad toe, triple toe in the short program. The ISU changed the rule just this season, and I think it makes it harder. You can't warm up. You just have to go right in and do the quad.
But that was not the performance that Todd Eldridge of the United States was looking for. We will see what the judges think when we come back to Boise, Idaho. We welcome you back to the Pearl Vision Masters. Coming up shortly, the ladies will take the ice for their short program. World silver medalist Irina Slutskaya of Russia will take on American world champion Michelle Kwan. Disappointed Todd Eldridge, his coach Richard Callahan, no quad in this short program.
And here you see His coach just said that he delayed it a little bit, and I think that's true. You know, he just overthought it probably. I don't know, I've never done a quad. Here he goes into triple axel. He gets nice height. He's nice and tight. He can't land this jump without turning out.
And now the marks for Todd Eldridge. See how costly his mistakes were. First set, 5-1s, 5-2s, and a 5-3.
Well, I think what you're looking at is a lower base mark and then a lot of nitpicky little deductions. That's what ISU competitions give you. They look at every single element, want it perfect.
And a much better second set for presentation, 5.8 for Todd Eldridge of the United States. Marks good enough for second place at this point in the competition. On the ice now, the final competitor for the men's short program, three-time and current world champion from Russia, Alexei Yagudin. He will skate to music by Chopin.
Tracy, when he came in here the other day for the practices, it was amazing. He did not miss a single jump. He dominated the whole practice, quads, triple axels, whatever. He looks so in control, and he is the complete skater. Here comes his quadruple toe loop. Quadruple toe loop. Double toe loop combination. Off to a great start. He gets right into another jump. This is the triple axel. Solid. See that? Such height, and then the control and the landing. Watch this death drop. Huge. Now this footwork is some of the most complicated in the business. Watch how he uses his upper body and his feet. Watch this little hitch. Reversing direction. This is just what the judges are looking for. Here is his triple Lutz out of footwork. Just puts it together like no other skater today.
That's the way to start your season. Three-time and current world champion from Russia, Alexei Yagudin.
Here's a quadruple toe loop like you'll never see right here in the short program. Look at the height and the tight legs. Did he touch his hand? I'm not sure. And a double toe loop. Now here are his skates. See the deep edges? Watch on the knee. Now watch, see if you can see the hand. I don't think he touched it. Oh, no, he
did not.
So that's a clean quad double.
Alexei with his coach, Tatiana Tarasova. Now the first set of marks for required elements, 2 5-7s, 3 5-8s.
I think those two thought that he touched his hand on that combination.
Five
nines across the board for presentation. So the current world champion, Alexei Yagudin of Russia, sits in first place after the short program ahead of the current Olympic champion, Ilya Kulik. Todd Eldridge of the United States is in third ahead of Stephen Cousins of Great Britain. Coming up next, the best in the world will take the ice, led by American Michelle Kwan.
You think it's hard being a world champion? Try taking up the game of golf. Watch out! Quad. I mean four. Whatever you would do in skating, you don't do in golf.
Butt out. Putt out. Then hit the ball. Yikes.
That's like the Zamboni man. Okay, ready?
Well, it's time for Michelle's brother, Ron, to lend a hand. Oh, I think Ron needs some help with his game as well.
Don't hit it so hard.
It's a light touch, right?
Getting some help on her putting. Where is Tiger Woods when you need him?
Yeah.
Tiger fist pump might help.
Congratulations, you scored a 76 on your first hole.
Yeah. How am I gonna get under that?
Nice shot. That was a good shot. That's what I call luck. Nice.
I'll do the slow Tiger Woods. Let's go.
Let's go, let's go.
Hey, Tiger, let's go to the rink now.
Stick with it. It's well worth it. But if you need any help, don't hesitate to call me. But don't expect to be have it reciprocal. I'm not getting on ice skates. I'm not gonna fall on my butt. So understand that, but you know my offer stands.
Ah, come on, Tiger. It'd be fun to see out there on the ice. But I guess Michelle Kwan will not be invited to Augusta next spring unless, of course, she gets some serious help from Tiger. But right now, along with Michelle, Irina Slutskaya is concentrating on the eight elements of the short program. Here is Irina and her unique description of the elements in her short.
First, it's combination with triple loops. I love this combination. It's true, I love all jumps. You know, sometimes I hate the triple loops. Now I love this jump. And after I do double ups. I do layback, like this. And this. After I stop and doing the steps. And combinations. Long combination spin, and I will stop. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Well, Roz, that was Irina's lighthearted look at the short program, but they're a little more serious today.
Oh, boy, nothing's lighthearted when you come out here on the ice. This is a short program, meaning you have to start ticking off the elements the minute the music starts.
And by virtue of a random draw, the Olympic eligible skaters will start things off. Led by the 1999 world champion from Russia, Maria Butyrskaya.
28 years of age, Maria Butyrskaya of Russia. She finished third at the recent World Championships.
We will see her marks when we come back and the performance of the second place finisher at Worlds, Irina Slutskaya.
It is time now for the Aflac trivia question. In what years did Katarina Witt win the World Championships? She won it four times. We will have the answer coming up later.
We're back at the Bank of America Center in Boise, Idaho, and a rather relieved Maria Butyrskaya is waiting for the marks of her short program.
Again, came right into the triple lutz double toe combination. She took her time on this takeoff, really reached back. A little bit of a two-footed landing. If the judges caught that, is definitely a deduction. Hard to see, but it was there.
And now the judges ready with the marks for Marina Butyrskaya. First set required elements and a deduction there, Ross.
Well, a couple 5-3s. She got a 3.3-tenth deduction on the two-footed landing of the triple lutz. Again, some of the judges might not have seen that. It was at the other end of the ice. But she did. That's one of the things she does do in a lot of her triples. She has to be careful.
Presentation marks 5-6, 5-7s, and 1-5-8. Maria Butyrskaya, the leader at this point in the competition. On the ice now, ready for her short program, Maria's teammate from Russia, 21-year-old Irina Slutskaya. She won the Russian National Championships this year and was the only skater to beat Michelle Kwan in competition last season. She did that at the Grand Prix Final. Second in the world. Tonight, Irina will skate to Elektra.
Boost your confidence to know that you were the one that beat Michelle Kwan. That has to really give you a lot going into the new season. She's going to open with the triple lutz double toe, same as Maria, same as Michelle. They're all going toe to toe here on the triples. She does it mohawk. Nice, solid. Look at that landing, just really right there. Irina just gets into a jump. She doesn't telegraph them. Not a lot of time to waste. A lot of speed across the ice. Here's the step sequence into the triple, which is the flip. Interesting. Nice.
As well as finishing second to Michelle this year at Worlds, Irina finished second to Michelle at the 1998 World Championship. She didn't make the world team in 99 and married that summer, and she really credits that with the turnaround in her skating.
Well, she's just done a turnaround in her body and her training, and it just shows so much. She's so much more mature.
Joyful on the ice.
Absolutely. Flying camel, interesting upside down position of her body. Again, the spins are very important. Can't take any of these elements lightly. Because she's not really a flashy skater. This really helps bring out the energy in her skating. Beautiful combination spin, a forward Bielman spin and a backward Bielman spin. Great flexibility. There you go. She just ticked those elements off. She has laid down the challenge for Michelle Kwan, Irina Slutskaya of Russia. Here's beautiful layback position into a forward Bielman spin. Her body is very reminiscent of a gymnast, actually. Stepping into a back camel spin, right into a back Bielman spin, keeping the speed up the whole time. Beautiful. And on the ice, listening to these marks, world champion Michelle Kwan. 5-7, 5-6, 5-8, 5-8, 5-9. Well, and these marks definitely coming up, a very energetic program. She had no mistakes. Again, Maria Butyrskaya put her toe down. This is where you're going to get down to picky deductions. Those marks were good enough for first place for Irina Slutskaya. Michelle Kwan, of course, on the ice. She has watched most of that program. She has heard the marks, and she knows that she's going to have to be clean. Roz, what kind of pressure is on her?
Well, you know what? Of all people, Michelle really doesn't use the other skaters as her pressure. She's already got enough pressure on herself.
She will skate to a new short program. Music by Eric Clapton, and the choreography for this is by world champion Christopher Dean.
Again, that alone is a challenge to work with an ice dancer, especially someone as innovative as Christopher Dean. Watch all the different angles Michelle gets. It's really quite a new look for her. Of course, everything always in control. She's going to open as her, really her warm-up for the program. Simple double axel. Nice. Michelle is very cool and collected in short programs. You never see really a hint of nerves. Okay, taking speed now into the triple lutz double toe. These have been so solid in practice. The other girls have landed them. Beautiful. And watch this cross the ice footwork step sequence. Here's the triple flip that she put in. Beautiful. Put it in last season. She got a lot of pressure to change it from a toe to a flip, and she just stepped right up to that challenge. One thing I noticed about Michelle is she elevates her skating even from practices to competing. Everything is crisper and solid. Going from the inside hedge to the outside edge, her trademark. Just look at the joy on her face. She's always happy to be skating, but there's a real sense of freedom, even in a short program. That's not something you usually see.
She wears it well, making it look easy. Michelle Kwan of the United States. Audience loved it. We will see what the judges think when we come back to Boise, Idaho.
The answer now to the Aflac trivia question, in what years did Katarina Witt win the world championships? 84, 85, Debbie Thomas of the United States won in 86. And Katarina again in 87 and 88.
We welcome you back to the Pearl Vision Masters in Boise, Idaho. Michelle Kwan waiting for her scores and discussing the program with Coach Frank Carroll.
Tracy, she actually said she felt a little slow. She says it was okay. If this is okay, I'd like to see what perfect is for here. Here's the triple lutz combination. Just perfect leg position, solid landing, taking her time into the double toe. If that's pretty good. Unbelievable. Here's the flip that she stepped up to last season and put in. Nice. And of course, the trademark spiral going from the inside edge. Unbelievable control in the hips. Changing over to an outside edge.
Michelle says that the hardest thing for her is keeping the motivation, the fire. That's the most important thing. Showed great energy, and the judges, they liked it as well. 2.57s, 2.58s, and a 5.9.
And these should come up again. Michelle, look at these 5.9s. Michelle taking the challenge to work with Christopher Dean. A whole new look. That's where the motivation comes from. Let's try something different. How can I push myself?
And right now, Michelle Kwan is the leader in the short program. On the ice now from the professional ranks.
Our next skater is
the 1994 world champion, turned professional, and won the world professional championships in 1995. 27 years of age from Japan, here is Yuka Sato. Music is the Islay Maiden by New England Sunrise.
Very different look, a very different feel than Michelle Kwan's program, choreographed by former national competitor Alan Schramm. She's going to open with a triple loop double toe, her most difficult triple. Ah, stepped out of the loop. Those were beautiful in practice. Again, this is where the knees get tight. Next jump is a triple sow. This isn't as difficult as the other three women's triple flips. Take your time, back edge, straight up. Nice. It's very hard to skate professional and then to walk back into an ISU short program. It's something you sort of get away from in the professional ranks. It's as hard as on your head as it is coming back and ticking off, like we said, those eight elements. Spinner. Look at the speed and the power in this camel. Lay back into a back sit spin. Beautiful body position. Everything is so finished and polished with Yuka. And she takes her time. Nothing is rushed. Well, I know she'll be a little disappointed in the step out in the triple loop, but it's a beautiful program.
Yuka Sato of Japan, she now lives in Michigan with her husband and coach, U.S. pair skater Jason Dungeon.
These have been going so well for Yuka in practice, but this is where she really has to use her knees. She got up in the air and just look at her whole body. Just starts to twist. She wasn't perpendicular. She had to step out of it. She did do the double toe, but that was a 0.3 deduction. Here's her beautiful layback position. Look at the extension of the arms. Her whole chest is just opened up. Beautiful leg position in the back into the back sit. Always a beautifully arched back. And now the scores for Yuka Sato of Japan. First set of marks required elements quite low raws, 5.0s, 5.2s, and a 5.3. Well, again, the loop wasn't as difficult as the triple lutzes that the other women were doing. And, of course, the triple sound, not the difficulty of the flip. But look at these marks for presentation. Her professional skating, poise evident in these marks. A convincing win in the short program for Michelle Kwan of the United States. She sits ahead of Irina Slutskaya and Maria Butyrskaya of Russia, Yuka Sato of Japan in fourth, ahead of Liu Chen of China. When we come back, Americans Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman and the rest of the pairs will skate their interpretive free program. We welcome you back to the Pearl Vision Masters at the Bank of America Center in Boise, Idaho, where the pairs are on the ice warming up for their interpretive free program. I'm Tracy Wilson, along with Rosalind Sumners, Dee Lynam, Paul Wiley, and Jim Huber. Now let's take a look at the skating order for the pair's interpretive. Starting things off, Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikhralidze of Russia. They're followed by American champions Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman. Zhuiya Zhan and Hongbo Zhao of China will skate last. And Paul, this is a very different program than the short. Give us what the judges are looking for in the interpretive free program.
Tracy, the judges are looking for aspects of skating that are rarely rewarded, namely choreographic effectiveness. And that means not how hard a move is, but how it goes to the music, and an integrated exploration of the music. In this case, I think Ina and Zimmerman have a great chance to move up in the standings.
First on the ice in the pairs event, Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikhralidze of Russia, and they've had little time to recover from their disastrous short program. They will skate to a number that is very comfortable for them. They've done it a number of times in exhibition. It's to the music Smooth by Santana. Two major mistakes on jumps in the short program and also some trips and falls. They're going to open here with the double axel. Side by side, beautiful. They have to put those mistakes from the short program behind them. Very interesting landing of the split double twist. She's landing on the top of his skates. Move coming out of a death spiral. Triple loop in the short program. This is the throw triple sow. Oh, God. She just came
can't hang on to the landing. She's so pitched forward. She actually looked like she landed on her face in that. Lift. This number choreographed by ice dancer Sasha Julin, and again, working with an ice dancer brings out such a different side of your edges and your basic skating. Unfortunate fall in the throw triple style, but again, that's what this number is not about. It is about the choreography, the feeling of the program, the interpretation of the music.
Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Tsukhalidze of Russia. And again, Roz, apart from that nasty fall, it was a strong program and much more what they're capable of.
And here was a beautiful side-by-side double axel warmed up. Look at how perfect their bodies are matched in the air and landing position, the unison, timing. Here's a very interesting start of a death spiral, and he just lifts her off the ice. Very innovative lift. And this fall, she gets so high on this, and if she comes down at all with a straight knee, she also looked like she slipped a little bit on the takeoff. She never got straight in the air right off the edge.
And now the marks for Yelena and Anton. 1.56, the rest 5.7s. Those marks for skating techniques, the second set of marks for presentation. 5.8s across the board.
Our next competitors representing the United States.
Well, they're sitting in second place after the short program. They did get two first place ordinals from the United States. Here are Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, and they will skate to My Baby You by Mark Anthony.
I was saying that this was a great opportunity for them. I really think this number shows off what they can do. Skate so romantically together. The judges are really looking for that. Open up with a very difficult move. This a triple split twist. Watch her split in the air, rotate three times, grabs her very nicely, sets her down. Moves that they've had trouble with in the past. Side-by-side double axels. Well done. Now look at her. get up to speed for this. Throw triple salchow. Wonderful height. This is a very important year for Ina and Zimmerman. They've really struggled to get up there at Worlds. They've been the U.S. champions, but they haven't placed in the top three, and this is obviously a building year for the Olympics.
In the past, Paul, they've shown moments of brilliance, but it looks tonight that they're really gelling as a pair.
They've just come back. John has just come back from a shoulder injury. I know that plagued him all last year, but he got it fixed this year, so I think that's helping. An innovative lift they call the book lift. Watch, she goes from an overhead one arm, and now she goes down in a book. He does a spread eagle. Very difficult and innovative. Remember, innovation is something that the judges are looking for and will reward in this program. So great to see them skating with this confidence, Tracy.
You can see just how happy they are with that performance. Americans Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, second after the short. We'll see how they do in the interpretive free when we come back to Boise. Coming up later, the men will take the ice, led by three-time world champion Alexei Yagudin. He's in first. Todd Eldridge gets another shot at the quad, and then the ladies with Liu Chen of China. We're back at the Pearl Vision Masters in the Bank of America Center. Just finished their routine. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman of the United States are waiting for their marks.
Here's the double axel, Tracy. Watch her position in the air. Very good. Perfectly together. Again, they've had some trouble with that in the past, so that's nice to have that behind them at the beginning of the season. And here is their book lift. Watch, they enter from an overhead. They go into a one arm. Watch her change her position, and now she'll go into a folded book, okay? And he's doing a spread eagle. Very difficult and very new, innovative.
They're coached by Tamara Moskvina, who also coaches Russian Zbereznaya Sikorlidze. She is known for her innovation. Let's see now what the judges think. First set of marks, Paul, 5 sixes and 2 5 sevens.
Well, I'm surprised, Tracy. I thought that they would get a little higher than that. They did side-by-side double axels.
5 sixes and 5 sevens again for presentation, and you can hear the audience obviously disapproves. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman are in second at this point in the competition. But the leaders, after the short program, from China, Zhue Zhen and Hongbo Zhao. They will skate to Beethoven's Last Night.
This is a brand new program for Shen and Chow, choreographed by Leanne Miller and Gorsha Sur. They went and spent all of August in China working with the Chinese skaters. They start off with an unusual forward outside death spiral. Split double twist, look at her up in the air. She delays that, it's amazing. Here come the side-by-side double axles. Very good. The jumps and the lifts and the jumps and the lifts and the twists, they do unbelievably. But it's the small things that get them. The unison, the footwork.
And Paul, this is a reach for them to do an interpretive program because they are not known as artistic skaters.
I think that's one of the things the ISU has in mind in doing these programs, is to push it a little bit on the artistic side of things. A one-arm star lift changing over. This program alternates between slow and intense pieces. I think the judges are looking for that range. Watch this. Throw triple salchow. They are apart. That's not as hard as when you jump close together like Bereznaya and Sikulica do. Look at this though. Very difficult forward takeoff into that lift. It's a nice departure for this couple. They're really working to try to get to the gold medal at the Olympics. They would be the that would be a first for China.
Second in the world this year, Joea Zhen and Hongbo Zhao. Paul, must be difficult for the judges to judge these routines tonight.
That's right, because, I mean, how do you decide what is choreographically effective, you know, and how much do you stray away from what you usually do in rewarding the technical elements? Here comes their star lift. Watch, he puts his hand on her hip, takes her up, and now watch her change of position. She goes to one hand and now rotates around. That's very difficult to do. And now, throw triple salchow. Watch the amplitude she gets on this. And the solid landing. That's the thing. She gets so high in the air, and she's soft on her landings.
Judges ready now with the marks for Joea Zhen and Hongbo Zhao. The first set for skating techniques. This is going to be very close. 5-6s and 3-5-7s.
I think that Ina and Zimmerman might just get them.
5-6, 5-6,
And the second set of marks range from 5.5, the rest 5.6s. And you're right, Zhen and Zhao have dropped to third place with that performance. So the final standings in the pairs event, Elena Berezhnaya, Anton Sikhalidze of Russia win the event, followed by Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman of the United States, Joya Zhen and Hongbo Zhao of China finish third. Let's go backstage now and join Dee Lynam.
Thanks, Tracy. I'm backstage with Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, and you guys early in the season, first competition out of the gate. Are you satisfied, Kyoko, with the way you guys, are you happy with this competition?
Yeah, I think we're really pleased with the way things went. We went out and we attacked the short. Didn't go perfectly, but it was okay, and the artistic program went really well, so we were very pleased.
John, you had shoulder surgery back in June, and many would say, wow, for a pair skater, this is going to be a major setback, but you two found a way to turn that into a positive. What did you all do in terms of your training that helped?
Well, after the surgery, you start from nothing again, basically. So we had to kind of reorganize our game plan for this year and basically start from zero, and we put it in high gear and went for it. And we still have a lot of ground to make up for for where we started, but I think we're on the way.
Very good. Thanks for taking the time. Tracy?
Thanks, Dean. A great start for Kyoko and John, second in this competition. When we come back, the men will take the ice for their interpretive free program. We're back at the Bank of America Center in Boise, Idaho. The men now on the ice warming up for their interpretive free program. Let's take a look back at the standings after the short program. In first place, the reigning world champion, Alexei Yagudin, followed by Ilya Kulik. Todd Eldridge of the United States missed his quad, finished third. Stephen Cousins is in fourth. So the skating order now for the interpretive free program has Todd Eldridge starting off, followed by Stephen Cousins, Alexei Yagudin, and Ilya Kulik. I'm Tracy Wilson, and I'm joined by Paul Wiley. No surprise that Alexei Yagudin is in first, but I think a bit of a surprise that Ilya Kulik is in second, Paul.
I think Ilya surprised even himself. He did an amazing triple axel, triple toe combination in the short program, and that leads him right into this wonderfully effective program that he's got planned here. He has been skating professionally for the last 2 years, skating in shows. It's a very unique program. He's a very expressive skater. He has all sorts of original moves I think that the judges will really like. This also could be his first competitive win since the Olympics.
Well, do you think this program is good enough to catch Alexei Yagudin?
Well, I do. The judges are going to really like him because he's a very complete skater. He skates with knives in his hands the whole time. He's been skating so well on practices here. He hasn't missed a single jump.
And what about Todd Eldridge? Does he try again for the quad and risk losing the competition? Or does he go for the win?
He is so determined to get to Salt Lake City and to have that quad in his program that I think he is going to go for the quad. And the reason is I think he's working right now on getting the commitment, the emotional and psychological commitment that it's going to take to get to Salt Lake City and put a quad in every single program.
Paul, he certainly does look focused. For more on Todd, let's go backstage now and join another member of our team, Jim Huber.
One of the most intriguing parts of covering any sport is an examination of an athlete's heart and soul, to somehow look deep inside, if that's possible, and find out what's creating the turmoil, what's responsible for the genius. Case in point, Todd Eldridge. He comes to this event a rebuild amateur. His two seasons off, either a chance to relax or a chance to rust. We will find out very quickly. But he also comes here with only one monumental goal in his mind, to finally medal at the Winter Olympics some 15 months from now. He's been near the top of his sport now for more than a decade, unheard of in the amateur ranks. But a spot on the Olympic podium has always eluded him for one reason or another. And it gets no easier. As he aims now at Salt Lake City, he knows he must do something he's never done before in competition, complete a quad. While those around him are doing two, three a performance, it remains a very important and gaping hole in his resume. And so all eyes will focus on that one moment. Will he or won't he? He completed four with no problem at all in his practice session here yesterday, and he told me afterwards that he would put one into his program tonight. But until he nails that one in competition, it will remain a dark cloud hanging over his comeback. Add that to the fact that each and every event from now until Salt Lake City must be treated as an Olympics, with all the mind games, all of the excitement and pressure, making Todd Eldridge's road to what surely will be his final Olympic shot just that much tougher. And that much more delicious if fulfilled.
Our first competitor in the interpretive men's free program from the United States, Todd Eldridge.
Thank you, Jim, and on the ice now. First competitor in the men's event, skating to music from the 13th Warrior soundtrack, here is Todd Eldridge.
The men's interpretive program is all about choreography. It's creativity, musical timing, and interpretation. Todd has all of this, but he's also putting a quad in the program.
And as in the short program, will open with his most difficult move first. Here comes the quad.
And I think he is determined to get this done tonight. Here it comes, quadruple toe loop. Yes! Great! That is an incredible barrier to cross for a skater. It is an emotional barrier. And he just crossed it. He has landed a quadruple in competition. Comes going into another difficult move. Triple axel, double toe loop. Awesome.
What a start for Todd Eldridge of the United States.
He's not going to stop there with the difficulty. Next move is a triple Lutz jump. Here it is, triple Lutz. Great! Program takes on a lot of different moves, Tracy. Watch this rhythmic footwork sequence. He's gone from fast to slow to dynamic.
Judges also looking for emotion.
Absolutely. Here comes a second triple axel. This is amazing.
Time to the music.
This is the kind of performance you'd expect to see at the end of the season, but remember, we're just beginning. Tracy, I don't think that Todd Eldridge could have skated this any better. It's just exactly what he came here to do. He breaks the quadruple toe loop barrier.
Regardless of the marks or the placement, that was a winning performance for Todd Eldridge. He took the risk, landed his first quad in competition. What an accomplishment. I talked to his coach, Richard Callahan, before this competition. I said, are you getting tired of everybody asking you about the quad? He says, I want him to get it done early in the season so we can move on. Todd did just that.
He was determined to do it when he came here. What a great night.
Paul, how many skaters would have taken the easy way out and not done it, not risked it in this interpretive program?
Oh, I think everybody. I mean, I think that that just shows that he is determined. Watch this. Here it is, the very first one. Watch how he gets in his knee. Watch the tightness of his feet. Unbelievable. Look at that. Look at those feet. Now watch as he goes into it. Beautifully tight feet. You can see his ankles. There's no air in there.
And you know Todd's sitting waiting for his marks, and he's enjoying watching these replays as much as
Let
we
Let me see
are.
That again.
First set of marks for Todd Eldridge, 5/8 across the board.
Paul 2.59s, that's great.
The long wait is over for Todd Eldridge, a quad in competition. Now, the journey to the Olympics can begin. We're back at the Pearl Vision Masters. Stephen Cousins waiting to skate. Let's go to Dee Lynam.
I am joined backstage with Todd Eldridge, who in competition has now landed a quad. I get to ask for the last time about the quad. No, but just the emotion of going into it, and then while you're in it, and then actually landing it. Can you take me through it?
Oh, I tell you, it's kind of been a rocking roller coaster here, but no, it's been going great in practice, and it's one of those things where, you know, going into it, it's felt a little bit different when I get actually in the competition. So I just try to go into it and think, all right, this is just another day of practice, and pull in and cross my fingers and hope for the best, I guess.
You said roller coaster after the short, which obviously didn't work out the way you would want. But it takes a lot to now get yourself back ready, and you don't have to do it in the interpretive free. Why did you?
You know, I guess I did it because it's kind of a personal thing for myself. You know, a lot of people have said, oh, he can't do it, he can't do it, he can't do it. Obviously, I can now. But, no, it's been a great thing. And it's something that, you know, I really wanted to do for myself. You know, whether or not other people thought I could do it or not, you know, it's something that personally I want to do myself.
Is this the great first step to take towards Salt Lake in 2002 for
definitely,
you?
Definitely. You know, this is obviously a very big step for me, and you know, knowing that I've done it and kind of getting that monkey off my back, you know, it's a great feeling, and hopefully I can take it from here, and, you know, hopefully good things will happen the next couple years.
Great to see. Thanks for sharing it with all of us.
Hey, my pleasure.
Back to you guys.
On the ice now from Great Britain, Stephen Cousins, and his strength is the way he lights up an audience. He's been professional for 2 years, and tonight he will skate to It's About That Walk.
Very entertaining, very interpretive. Stephen Cousins, great performance.
Stephen's marks and a lot more skating when we come back. Stephen Cousins and coach Robert Tebbe wait for their scores.
Here comes Stephen's triple flip. Watch his air position. And watch his right arm. Look how big it is. Gets right in there. Nice tight feet. And then a little playing at the end. Here comes his Lutz. Watch him reach back on the backward outside edge. Harder jump because it's a counter rotation. Nice tight feet. Great landing. And look at these cool moves that right out of it. Having fun.
Stephen Cousins along with coach Robert Tebbe, and now his first set of marks. 5 fives and 5 sixes, Paul.
Well, I don't think what he wanted out of it, but pretty good marks. You know, he did a couple.
And the second set of marks, 5 sevens across the board, 1 5 6.
Those go up. You can see how he entertained the crowd.
On the ice, the leader after the short program, he's the three-time current world champion, Alexei Yagudin of Russia. And he will skate to music from the Gladiator soundtrack.
Tracy, this is a very dramatic program. He will skate with these knives in his hands the whole time, which is very difficult because you're actually clenching your fist, which means you're under a little bit of tension in your arm. He'll do all sorts of jumps with them. Starting off here with a triple flip. He has such a command over these triple jumps. That's just easy for him. Triple axel. Little step out, but you can see the height there. Watch the complexity of this footwork. Very difficult steps, clever. Tatiana Tarasova told me that they've worked on this program. She's so proud of it.
Alexei told me that when he went to see this movie, he identified with the lead character because despite difficult circumstances, he remained true to himself.
Technical ability here. These are innovative moves, these slides that he's doing. Every year, Alexei chooses how he's going to go about his year, and he ratchets up both the technical and the artistic difficulty. He is determined to lead the whole pack. Triple toe loop. Very dramatic performance, Tracy.
In so many different ways, it was emotional. And Paul, the way you pointed out that he used his footwork, the music throughout, difficult, not just in terms of his jumps, but in every step in the program. Alexei Yagudin of Russia, the current world champion. And let's see what the judges think. We'll find out right after this. Back in Boise, Idaho, Alexei Yagudin, coach Tatiana Tarasova, sitting waiting for the marks.
Now here comes his triple axel. Remember, he's got knives in his hands. Watch him go straight up in the air, and I think he's just a little bit over-rotated, just a little off the back of his skate. Now watch this footwork. Unbelievable use of his edges, stopping and starting, toe work, low work. It's all incredibly difficult. It's all what the judges love.
Now time to see what the judges thought of the performance of Alexei Yagudin, a mixture of 5 sevens and 5 eights for the first set of marks, Paul, and it's gonna be tight.
I think they were looking for something that didn't look like a long program.
Second set of marks, 1 5 seven, 2 5 eights.
This is awfully close.
That is good enough for second place. Todd Eldridge is the leader. On the ice now, he's in second place after the short program. He's worked hard on this program. It is his own invention, his own choreography. Here is Ilya Kulik. The music that he will skate to is Rocket by Herbie Hancock.
Ilya has incredible body control. Again, he came up with all of this choreography himself, and I think he loves being his own person. Triple Lutz with sunglasses on, yeah. That's a flying Kulik right there. There's a little variation on the death drop. Effective footwork, goes right with the music. He looks like he's got rubber legs or something. Here he goes in a triple flip. Little turnout. Look at this. He has incredible flexibility and movement.
Mm-hmm. very difficult to choreograph your own work because you never know how it looks.
Absolutely.
Ilya brought somebody in to video his practices, studied it at home on the monitor, and then came back to the rink and fine-tuned it.
Look at this footwork. It's not an Olympic long program, but it is interpretive. And watch this.
Fantastic.
Well, Tracy, I have no idea what the judges are going to do with this one. I mean, great program, very effective, but it doesn't look like an Olympic long program. So are they going to like it?
Not supposed to look like an Olympic long program. This is the interpretive free skater, Ilya Kulik. Well done. Very much a departure from anything we've ever seen him do. He said after the Olympics he was tired of focusing on the jumps. He wanted to start doing innovative moves.
Here's his flying Kulik. See that? It's a death drop, but then he gets into a forward sit spin. Very, very innovative. Now look at this. Look at this position he gets into. Flexibility, innovation. Now, look at this footwork. Unbelievable use of his edges and toe work. Very difficult. It's very difficult not to trip over yourself doing this. And it all went with the music.
Judges ready with the marks for Ilya Kulik. The first set of marks, 2.56s, 3.57s. It's very close amongst the men.
It really is. I mean, it's too close to call.
And look at these marks for presentation. 5.9s across the board, 1.57. But that is not enough. In fact, Ilya Kulik drops to third place with that performance. The winner for the third year in a row, Todd Eldridge of the United States. In second place, a current world champion, Alexei Yagudin of Russia. Ilya Kulik in third. Stephen Cousins of Great Britain in fourth. Tonight, Todd Eldridge joined the Quad Club. And now it's on to a bigger goal in Salt Lake City. Up next, the momentum shifts to the ladies, where Maria Butyrskaya hopes to recapture some past skating magic. And Irina Slutskaya sets out to prove that her success last year was no fluke. And of course, Michelle Kwan will continue to silence some doubters. The ladies, next. We're back for the Pearl Vision Masters at the Bank of America Center, and Michelle Kwan of the United States has taken the ice along with the rest of the ladies for the warm-up of their interpretive free program. Let's take a look back at the ladies standing after the short. Finished the same way they did at the World Championships this year, with Michelle Kwan in first, Irina Slutskaya in second, ahead of Maria Butyrskaya, Yuka Sato, and Liu Chen finished fifth. Skating order now for the interpretive free program has Yuka Sato starting things off, followed by Liu Chen, Irina Slutskaya. Michelle Kwan of the United States will skate fourth, and Maria Butyrskaya will finish last.
I'm Tracy Wilson along with Rosalind Sumners. And Rosalind, Michelle Kwan looks so strong in the short program. Is her interpretive free program as good?
Absolutely is. She looks so strong. And you know what? Michelle is silencing the doubters. She's silencing the critics. She is on the game plan on the way to Salt Lake City. She and Frank have a game plan. That is Frank's strength as a coach, and Michelle trusts him. She really, you know, it's not about just winning an Olympic gold. It's all about competing. She loves to compete. She learns about herself as a person, as a dedicated athlete. And you learn and you grow if you push past all the boundaries. She doesn't even see those boundaries. She is what is pushing the sport to new heights.
Well, another skater who is quite feisty, Maria Butyrskaya, very emotional. This program must suit her.
Well, it does suit her. She's very charismatic on the ice. This is where she shines. And, you know, this is definitely a three-way rival. And Maria, being the oldest out there at 28 years old, this is her time. She wasn't on the podium at the Olympics. She lost her world title this year to Michelle. She lost her six-year reign as Russian champion to Slutskaya. You know, these are huge disappointments. She needs to come out here in every single competition. She needs to conquer all those past demons.
And then there's Irina Slutskaya, who you mentioned, she's on quite a roll.
She is, and she is capable of technical brilliance. You know, she beat Michelle Kwan at the Grand Prix Final, hitting seven triples, including triple salut, triple loop, and the first triple lutz, triple loop ever done by a woman. And you know what? She's the one pushing the others. She's pushing Michelle to do the triple-triple. Butyrskaya is working on the triple axel. Now, she's got a very simple style. She's not flashy. You know, she's very old school, but she definitely doesn't blur the lines. She is an eligible skater.
In 1996, Irina captured the world's attention when she won the European Championships. For this 21-year-old, a marriage last year rekindled her career. Yesterday, we spent the day with this engaging young lady following her long journey from Moscow to Boise. She's the subject of our Pearl Vision Closer Look. 8 o'clock in Boise,
out of home. My trip was incredible. We fly about 10 hours to New York, about 5 hours to Salt Lake City, and 45 minutes to Boise. We go to skating rink. I want to see where I will skate tomorrow and tonight in the practice, and everything like this. This place is cute. Now I want to go shopping. I find my shopping center is here. Let's go. Oh, it's so nice. With me, huh? I want to change my color. How do you think? Where's everyone? I didn't see anything. This is me right now, and I think I go sleep right here. Snowboards, snowboards. Yee-hoo. Oh, I want to buy everything. They're so big. I need something small. I think I need bigger size. Oh, yeah. It's cool one. How do you think? Hey, I have new pants. I think it's good. I'm ready. Now I need just snow and mountains. Thank you very much. What do you think? I'm just starting shopping. Bye. Okay. Yeah. Now I must be serious and I go take rest. We'll see you later. Bye. What's your name?
What's your name? Well, after a tiring day yesterday, Irina's looking very focused here as she prepares for the interpretive free skate. She's in second place after the short behind Michelle Kwan of the United States. We will have their interpretive free skate coming up.
Thank you.
ice for the ladies' interpretive free program from Japan, Yuka Sato, and she finished fourth in the short program. Yuka will skate to Take My Hand.
Touch my skin and tell me what you're thinking. Take my hand and show me where we're going. Lie down next to me, look into my eyes.
She's going to open with the triple loop. Watch the ease of the knee bend. Flying camel, look at the stretched arms. Triple toe. It's very important that the jumps are well paced throughout the program. Skates pairs with her husband, Jason Dungeon. She said it helps her single skating, makes her stronger. They will compete a little later in the season in the pairs event at the Japan Open. What I love about this music is the lyrical words, and she's skating to that. At the same time, there's the underlying beat that she's using with it. Triple, and she comes right out of it and steps right into intricate footwork so perfectly to the music. And she is using the ice from boards to boards. Great coverage. Making it look so smooth, so easy. Tremendously talented skater, and I think she comes by it honestly. Both her parents were figure skaters, represented Japan in the Olympics in the 60s. We'll have Yuka's marks when we come back to Boise, Idaho.
Backstage, Michelle Kwan listening to this appreciative audience as she prepares for her turn on the ice. Yuka Sato now waiting for the marks from the judges and Roz. Yuka is really a skater's skater. Purists love her style.
Well, reminiscent of the skating from Janet Lin. I mean, look at this extension on this flying camel. Pointed toe, nothing is overlooked with Yuka.
Here now, the marks for Yuka Sato, unanimous. 5 sevens across the board.
Well, she did the loop in the sow. She doesn't have a flipper a lot.
And Ra's presentation marks, very strong also.
Nice.
And on the ice now, waiting for her turn from China. Here is Lu Chen. She was in fifth place after the short program, and for her interpretive free, she will skate to Within You, Without You.
She has an unbelievably exquisite style. This is a piece of music that suits her. Watch her body work throughout the whole program. Very expressive. Again, that's what this program is about.
Like Yuka, she is a professional skater, and so she has that advantage of performing day in, day out in front of audiences.
But she's still gonna have to do the triples. She didn't even land one in the short program. So this first triple toe, this is a demon that she's got to face. She needs to really go for it. Nice, good for her. That's a huge step for Lulu. Double axel. She goes very slowly into her jumps. Doesn't have a lot of speed across the ice. She really then needs to use her knees. The music changing, picking up the pace. She's going to try a triple loop. No, she was going way too slow, couldn't get off the takeoff. Chen, a two-time Olympic bronze medalist, and after the Olympics in Nagano in 1998, she turned professional, had a very difficult time adjusting. She has moved to Scottsdale, Arizona, and says she feels very comfortable, very settled there, and her skating has shown that she's feeling better about herself. Well, it took her a while, Tracy, to find her home here, and she's very comfortable working with Doug Ledre, who she actually spent a lot of time with on tour. She's found a connection. He's very motivating for her. It's not a strict coaching situation for her, and she's really shining under it. She's going to try one more triple, the triple sow. Two-footed landing, but she tried it. That can be a conditioning problem. fun program. Liu Chen of China, she was in fifth place after her short program. We'll see how she does in the interpretive free skate when we come back to Boise, Idaho.
We are backstage, and I am joined by Yuka Sato. And Yuka, you are a world champion, but I want to know, what is it like to compete against the current world gold, silver, and bronze?
Well, even though I have been participating in the Pro-Am event every single year, it's been a few years since I started doing that. It's getting harder and harder every year. Everybody else's level has gone up, and I haven't really changed. So I don't know. It's very... uptight feeling for me.
Okay, that said, then when you take the ice for the interpretive free, there's just this look of peace on your face. But at this stage in your career, is it more important how you skate than necessarily what place you finish?
Definitely, I really care about how I skate, how I feel out there, and how I attack for my own performance level. And when I can't do it, I think it's time for me to go, but I still have the fire for that, so I think it's a good sign.
Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you.
Liu Chen waits with her coach, Doug Ledre, for marks for interpretive free skate. And her first set of marks range from 5.4 to 5.6.
And they're low. She did a triple toe and one double axel. And, you know, the program was a little slow, but she's conquering a lot for herself.
Second set of marks go up, 5.5s, 1.56, and 1.57 for Liu Chen. That will put her into second place at this point in the competition. Yuka Sato is in first. And on the ice now, she was second to Michelle Kwan at the World Championships this year. Second after the short program. Here is 21-year-old Irina Slutskaya of Russia. And she will skate to music from Schindler's List. When she heard this piece of music, she said she felt it in her heart right away. She says she knows this program will be a success if somebody walks away and feels a little bit of what she feels while skating this number. Matured so much in the past few years. This number is such a combination of her strengths, the technical strength. Look at that gorgeous layback. A much softer side of Irina. Miss anything in practice. She is just spot on. Watch this, simple three turns without putting your foot down, right into a triple loop.
she knows that she can beat Michelle on the technical level, but Michelle keeps pushing herself artistically, and that is what's going to push Irina to try to catch that if she's going to beat her again. She really felt that piece of music. The jumps were just right there. They enhanced the performance. It was not about the technical. It wasn't about the jumps. This was beautiful for her.
I agree, Roz. I think for the first time, Irina Slutskaya just had everybody in this audience drawn into her performance. We'll see how she affected the judges and the performance of Michelle Kwan when we come back to Boise, Idaho. We're back in Boise, Idaho. Irina Slutskaya going up to her marks. Michelle Kwan on the ice, waiting for her turn of the interpretive free program.
And here's the triple S. She takes off no hesitation, right from the Mohawk. Look at the leg position in the air. And that is about as solid a landing as you could ask for. Here's a beautiful combination spin. Just look at the speed going into the camel, into the sit, into a gorgeous layback position, right into a full over-the-head Bielman spin. But look at the speed of her spinning. Nothing slows down. Right into a back camel, back Bielman. She doesn't use spins for a rest in her program. Again, they're part of her technical strength.
Well, with performances like that, you sense a tremendous rivalry coming between Irina and Michelle Kwan. And look at these marks. All 5'8", 159. And a terrific set of presentation marks as well. 5'8" with 159 for Irina Slutskaya of Russia. And that puts her in first place at this point of the competition, ahead of Yuka Sato and Liu Chen. But on the ice now, the leader after the short program, 20 years of age, here is Michelle Kwan. And her music, Beautiful World. Double axel as a warm-up for herself in the program.
See you in the street.
There we just saw a camel spin the opposite direction of her normal spinning, then into a sit spin her way. Beautiful. She does it for herself. She absolutely wants to be out here with this feeling. She always delivers every program with such confidence, such class. Absolutely.
Michelle Kwan of the United States, again, delivering a beautiful performance.
Here's the beautiful inside spiral, inside edge. Changes right over to an outside edge without ever dropping the free leg. Unbelievable strength. Now, she really wanted a triple on this sow cow here. She just got off her heel. Oof, just went right off. Couldn't finish the rotation, but she came right back with a beautiful triple toe, double toe combination. Michelle never lets the mistakes bother her or affect the rest of her performance. Michelle Kwan is going to need very high marks to hold up Irina Slutskaya of Russia. And these just might be enough. It is still close, though. 5-8s across the board, except for the 1-5-9. These marks will tell the story.
Oh, my gosh.
A perfect mark. Oh, another perfect mark.
You know what?
Michelle.
She put so much feeling into her skating, Tracy. That is absolutely 6.0 emotion. She deserves that.
Michelle Kwan, another 6.0, and that turns into another first place finish so far in the competition. Michelle in first, Irina Slutskaya in second, but there is one skater left to skate. She's on the ice. You may not recognize her. She used to be a blonde. Here is Maria Butyrskaya of Russia, portraying Cleopatra.
And boy, this is a tough position to skate in. All the skaters are done. Michelle has just finished with a 6.0. Boy, this is where you gotta block it all out and just do your job at hand. Open with the triple Lutz. It was beautiful in the short program. Hung on.
Oh.
she hangs onto those landings. You know, you see a determination in a fight. Before, she might have let that go, but... great use of arms in this layback. Again, staying with the character of Cleopatra throughout the whole number. Wow, landing a triple toe, but again, she never puts you at ease on these jumps. Double axel to end the program. The only thing about this piece of music is it's kept a pace the same throughout the whole. There's been no variation within the music.
It leaves me cold, and I think it affects the audience in the same way.
It's interesting, and it's a very intriguing piece of music and a tough choice, a real challenge, but there's just something missing in the music. Butyrskaya of Russia. Give her full marks for trying something totally different. Roz, did you like it?
I did, but and you never know when you try something new, Tracy. That is the challenge of being an artist. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And again, this is a new program. This will grow for her. And she fought on all these triples. Here's the opening triple Lutz. Watch the knee bend. She's fine in the air, and then right at the last second, that left arm just opens out away from her, and she has to put the other foot down. Newly brunette Maria Butyrskaya of Russia, and here's her marks. Well, Tracy, these are low. Again, the three triples, nothing was delivered with ease. Very scratchy landings. Looked to me as though she was thinking through this program, not comfortable with it at all. And that's reflected in these marks. 3.57s, a 5.8, and 5.9. And those marks will drop Maria Butyrskaya of Russia into fourth place. The winner for the third consecutive year, Michelle Kwan of the United States, ahead of Irina Slutskaya of Russia. Yuka Sato of Japan moves up to third. Butyrskaya in fourth. Liu Chen of China in fifth. Now let's go backstage and join Dee Lynam, who's with Michelle Kwan.
Thanks, Tracy. I am joined by Michelle Kwan. And Michelle, start of a new season. Again, you have a first place finish, but we just don't ever see anything drop. How is that in your performances?
Well, I didn't fall, but I kind of opened up on the sow cow. Got a little tired. It's hard doing two programs in one day, especially when, you know, I'm debuting my short program, so most of my focus went into the short. And then afterwards, I only had an hour to recuperate and think about the exhibition program. So I'm glad it went pretty well.
Actually, you brought that up. Were you surprised then that you had that one perfect score?
Yeah, I was like, whoa, I like those. Especially when you make mistakes and you get a six. But it's not as satisfying, I can tell you that.
All right, thanks for taking the time.
Mistake or otherwise, Michelle Kwan remains the premier ladies figure skater in the world. This rose kept her bloom tonight. Some final remarks when we return.
Pearl Vision Masters on TNT has been brought to you by Monistat, the number one doctor-recommended brand for the treatment of yeast infections. By Wendy's Bacon Mushroom Melt. When you gotta have one, you gotta have one. By AIM Mutual Funds. Call your financial advisor for a prospectus. And by Pearl Vision. Nobody cares for eyes more than Pearl.
As the skaters say their final goodbyes to Boise, we're reminded of the long competitive season ahead for the Olympic eligibles. Programs will need refining, and the world will await those adjustments. Once again, here is Jim Huber.
Thanks, Tracy. How appropriate it is, a not so subtle reminder of what lies just around the next mountain pass, that figure skating would begin the most crucial part of its journey to the 2002 Winter Olympic Games just across the border from Salt Lake City. Boise thus begins what golf would call its moving day, the key players putting themselves in position for that stretch run. The judges here tonight getting their first looks at these skaters' new programs, their first of many such looks as the events lead us toward a medal platform 2 Februarys from now. It's an interesting part of the process, really, for the judges will take a skater aside occasionally after this and say, look, your music doesn't really suit you. You need a new spark. And then see what their advice produces in the next show down the line. What can we expect in that adventure? Many believe we have yet to see the woman who will mysteriously come out of the pack to put the real heat on Kwan and Butcherskaya and Slitskaya. That there is someone out there, somewhere, preparing herself. Kind of unlikely for the men. The prime contenders now, Yugudin, Plushenko, Stoiko, Weiss, a reinvented Eldridge after tonight, figure to be the prime contenders in 15 months. The question on that side is how much maturity can the young Yevgeny Plushenko muster to somehow stop Yugudin from first his fourth straight world championship and then the gold. And speaking of maturity, what of Todd Eldridge as he returns to the Olympic eligible ranks for what surely must be his last shot at an Olympic medal? The 30-year-old New Englander finally finding the quad he's so desperately looking for, and could that be the key to a spot on the platform at last? We have seen brilliance and glory tonight here, but as the shadow of Salt Lake City looms, we have only seen the bare beginnings. It promises to be a wonderful ride.
Thank you, Jim. And what a ride it will be. The next stop for TNT on this Olympic journey will be December 17th for the Pearl Vision Canadian Open. The short program begins at 1 Eastern, followed at 9 with the interpretive free programs. Michelle Kwan and Elvis Stoiko will headline the field. For Rosalind Sumners, Paul Wiley, Dee Lynam, and Jim Huber, I'm Tracy Wilson saying good night from Boise, Idaho.